We have seen the equations of an electromagnetic wave that is moving in positive z direction. The equations were Ex is equal to some constant E0 sin kz minus omega t, By is equal to B0 sin kz minus omega t, where k is 2 pi by lambda, lambda is the wavelength of this wave. What is wavelength? Wavelength is simply the distance traveled in one oscillation. Distance traveled in one oscillation is called the wavelength. So this is our wavelength, and k is equal to nothing but 2 pi by lambda. So this is our k, and called wave vector. K is called wave vector. What is omega? Omega is, as we know, omega is angular frequency, angular frequency of this wave. K is the magnitude of the wave vector. So this is small k, small k without any vector sign is magnitude of the wave vector, or sometimes called propagation vector. K, and this cap, this k, bold k, is, that means we have a vector form, and its direction describes the direction of propagation of the wave. So this k and its direction gives the information about the direction of the propagation of wave. The speed of propagation of the wave is omega by k. So what is the speed of the propagation of wave? That is omega by k. Using the equations, these two equations for Ex and By and Maxwell's equation, one finds that. So now we are using these two equations in, we are putting these two equations in Maxwell's equation. So this is, what is the velocity of the wave? Omega by k. Let us see how this is the speed of the wave. So we are saying this v is equal to, this is velocity v, is equal to, or let us say speed, not the direction, speed, omega upon k. So let us put the value. Omega is 2 pi by t, this t is time period, and k is 2 pi by lambda. So this 2 pi and 2 pi cancelled out, what we get? Lambda upon t. And what is 1 by t? 1 by t is nothing but nu, and we know this lambda nu is nothing but velocity. In this way, omega by k is velocity of the wave. So this lambda v, lambda nu, sorry, lambda nu is the velocity of the wave, which we have written in this form, omega upon k. So in this way we can measure the, what is the speed of the wave. So we are using these two equations in Maxwell's equation, and what we get? So we get omega is equal to ck, because we have said this omega by k is velocity, and we have considered, instead of v, we are considering this to be a constant, or c. C is the speed of the wave. So omega is equal to simply ck, and when we solve, we find this c is nothing but 1 upon under root mu 0 and epsilon 0. So here we are considering this 1 upon under root mu 0 epsilon 0, but proof of this is very difficult and it is out of the scope of this course. So we are not going to prove, we are going to just see that c is nothing but 1 upon mu 0 epsilon 0. The proof is very difficult and involves many differential and integrals. Now the relation omega is equal to ck is the standard one for the waves. See, for the example 15.4 of class 11th physics, so we have already learned these things. This relation is often written in terms of frequency. Frequency is omega upon 2 pi, and wavelength is nothing but 2 pi by k. So when we put it here, so omega is equal to ck, so omega is 2 pi nu, and c is here, and k is 2 pi by lambda. So when we solve, this 2 pi and 2 pi cancelled out, what we get? Nu lambda is equal to c, because we have considered velocity to be c or speed to be c. So in this case we get nu lambda is equal to c, and c is the speed of light. If we solve this problem, if we solve this number, what we get? We get स्पीड ऑफ लाइट बट प्रूफ इज नॉट इन आवर कोर्स. सो इफ वी सॉल्व दिस सी अपॉन वन बाई अंडर रूट वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ म्यू जीरो. म्यू जीरो इज नथिंग बट 4π × 10⁻⁷ इंटू एप्साइलन जीरो इज 8.85 × 10⁻¹². ऑन सॉल्विंग वॉट वी गेट, वी गेट 4π इज नथिंग बट दिस इज 12.56 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 8.85 एंड दीज टू पावर्स कंबाइन एंड वी गेट पावर 10⁻¹⁹. नाउ फर्दर सॉल्व इट. सो वॉट वी गेट, वन अपॉन वेन वी मल्टीप्लाइड वॉट वी गेट, वी गेट 111.156. सो दिस वी गेट इंटू 10⁻¹⁹. टू सॉल्व इट वॉट वी डू, वी रिमूव दिस डेसिमल एंड वी टेक इट हेयर. सो दिस बिकम्स 10⁻¹⁸. सो लेट मी राइट इट हेयर. सो दिस विल बिकम अंडर रूट एंड दिस इज वन बाई, दिस इज वन बाई अंडर रूट 11.11 इंटू 10⁻¹⁸. सो वेन दिस 10⁻¹⁸ कम्स आउट दिस विल बी 10⁻¹⁹ एंड अंडर रूट ऑफ दिस क्वांटिटी इज 3.34. एंड वेन वी सॉल्व दिस नंबर वॉट वी गेट, दिस बिकम्स 1/3, 1/3.34, दिस बिकम्स 0.3 एंड वेन वी टेक दिस अपसाइड सो वी गेट 10⁻¹⁸. वेन वी सॉल्व दिस नंबर वी गेट 3 × 10⁻¹⁸, दैट इज द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट. सो इन दिस वे वी सॉ इन वैक्यूम. सो दीज आर द permeability and permittivity for the vacuum. So in vacuum the electromagnetic waves travel with the speed of light, but the proof of this equation is not in our course. We have just assumed that this is true, this is true, and the speed of electromagnetic waves in vacuum is equal to the speed of light. Now another important thing, it is also seen from Maxwell's equation that the magnitude of electric and magnetic fields in an electromagnetic waves are related as. So what is the relation? The relation is B0 is nothing but E0 by C, and this is for the magnitude where C is the speed of light or speed of the propagation. So this is another formula that we have to remember. This also comes from Maxwell's relation. We here make remarks on some features of electromagnetic waves. So let us try to understand some of the features. They are self-sustaining oscillations of electric and magnetic field in free space or vacuum. So first of all, they can travel in free space or vacuum and they are self-sustaining. They differ from all other waves we have studied so far in respect that no material medium is involved in the vibration of electric and magnetic field. So what is the difference? First of all, their self-sustaining waves have both electric and magnetic field, can travel in space or vacuum. And what is the difference between these waves and all other waves that we have previously studied? That no material is involved. No material is involved in the vibrations of electric and magnetic field. Previously, there was some kind of material was involved in the vibration of either vibration of a string or vibration of waves. Some kind of material was involved, but here no material is involved. Sound waves in air are longitudinal waves of compression and rarefaction. So what are sound waves? Sound waves are longitudinal waves and these waves are propagated through compression and rarefaction. And what is the medium that vibrate? That is air. Transverse electric sound waves can also propagate in a solid which is rigid and that raise the shear. So transverse electric waves can also propagate in a solid which is, solid is a rigid and that can resist the shear, but again there is a medium of vibration. Scientists in the 19th century were so much used to this mechanical picture that they thought that there must be some form of medium pervading all space and all matter. So since scientists were very very much familiar with this notion of any matter, so scientists have not seen any waves that can vibrate or that can sustain outside material. So they think, what they thought that there must be some medium. There must be some medium that is in vacuum. There is some medium which responds to electric and magnetic fields just as any elastic medium does. So what they thought there that there is some kind of medium which they called ether. They called that medium ether, and this medium is not visible to us, but there is some kind of medium which is sustaining this these electric and magnetic fields. They were so convinced of the reality of this medium that there is a novel called The Poison Belt by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. So this idea that there must be some medium in vacuum as well, so there was a novel on this, The Poison Belt, Sir Arthur Conan Doyle. Who was Arthur Conan Doyle? He was the creator of famous detective Sherlock Holmes. So he wrote another novel, The Poison Belt. What happens in this poison belt? The solar system is supposed to pass through a poisonous region of ether. So what solar system was doing? It was passing through a poisonous region of ether. We now accept that no such physical medium is needed. Now in reality, after about more than 100 years, now we know that there is no medium needed. The famous experiments of Michelson and Molle demolished conclusively the hypothesis of ether. So there were two scientists, Michelson and Molle. They did some kind of experiment, and with the help of this experiment, they showed that there is no ether. Electric and magnetic fields oscillating in space and time can sustain each other in vacuum. So what we learn, these waves can propagate through vacuum and self-sustaining. So previously scientists were so habitual of this notion of any medium, so they thought that even in vacuum there is a medium ether, but that was not there. These waves can travel through vacuum without any medium.